Hi, I'm Dr. Jason Barker with the Natural Athletes Clinic. Have you ever considered using proteolytic enzymes as part of your sports recovery program? Well, if you haven't, I'm hoping I can convince you to use those today because they do a couple of amazing things in your body. Proteolytic enzymes will actually speed up the tissue repair process and decrease the amount of time it takes you to heal, all the while providing a very strong anti-inflammatory effect. All of this done, of course, naturally. So what are enzymes? They are essentially proteins that speed up other biochemical reactions. They act as catalysts in your body. So normally your body does this on its own. However, when you get injured, and especially if it's a severe injury, those systems get quickly overwhelmed, so that we can use enzymes as a supplement instead to help speed up that tissue repair. Now, back in the day in the 60s, doctors actually used to prescribe proteolytic enzymes for healing and tissue repair. But that kind of fell by the wayside as corticosteroid drugs and non-steroidal anti-inflammatories flooded the market. It wasn't that the enzymes didn't work as well, it's just that the other drugs were better distributed and cheaper to make. But the big difference between using a corticosteroid or an NSAID drug and an enzyme is that those drugs don't do anything to speed up tissue repair and actually help the body heal. They're good at removing pain, they're good at decreasing inflammation, but what enzymes do, the magic part of the enzymes is that they actually speed up that tissue repair process. So, a couple reasons why we want to use proteolytic enzymes whenever you have a sports injury. So, first one is that they decrease the amount of inflammatory chemicals known as bradykinins in the body. They'll actually inhibit the production of our pro-inflammatory prostaglandins, which are a class of hormones in the body, and they'll actually increase the amount of anti-inflammatory prostaglandins. They'll also support the production of other enzymes in the body, because remember, they're catalysts, so they'll actually speed up other enzymatic reactions that help help that tissue repair. And then one of the really cool things they do is they actually degrade the proteins that have leaked out of an injured or a damaged cell, because those proteins themselves can become very irritating to that surrounding tissue and cause their own injury. So the enzymes actually clean things up. They also help break down fibrin, which is yet another protein that your body makes to create clots. So once the bleeding is stopped, we don't really need that fibrin around. So the enzymes will break that down so that you can bring in fresh blood and deliver those nutrients to speed up that healing process. Now, we get enzymes from plants and animals. Plant sources are things like papaya. We get papain from that. Bromelain, of course, comes from pineapple. Rutin comes from a couple of other different types of plants. And then we get trypsin and chymotrypsin and pancreatin from animal sources. Now, once you get your hands on some enzymes, you want to use a broad spectrum with plant and animal based, because while they are proteolytic enzymes, they do all have their own individual actions that they use. So, of course, synergy is always better when we're using these. So look for, like I said, a broad spectrum instead of just using a product that just has one enzyme in it. And of course, we love systemic enzyme complex from pure encapsulations. And then I've always used Wobenzyme, which has been on the market, I think, for like 3 decades now. That's good stuff too. So enzymes are great for acute injuries. Okay, so as soon as you get injured, you need to start using them immediately. And then you can even use them before, during, and after an event in which you think you're going to be injured. So maybe if you're a boxer, or if you're a mixed martial artist, or maybe if you're gonna run a race that's really hilly where you know you're gonna be sore from it. So in studies, when we use the enzymes before, during, and immediately after an event like that, people have experienced about 50% decrease in swelling and a 50% decrease in time it takes to heal and recover. So those are pretty impressive statistics with that. So big things, though, that you need to know with the enzymes, or a drawback, I guess, is that you've got to take a lot of them. They need to be dosed about 4 times a day because you want to keep them circulating through your body, of course, so it can help heal up that injured area. And then the other important thing is they need to be taken on an empty stomach. Okay, if you take proteolytic enzymes with food in your belly, all that enzymatic energy is going to go towards digesting that food rather than getting out into the circulation. So make sure you take them on an empty stomach. Okay, guys, so that's that. I hope I can convince you to use proteolytic enzymes. I use them myself. I do feel like they heal up my recovery time. They definitely keep me from getting sore. So if you enjoyed the video, give it a like. Of course, please share it with any of your buddies who complain about getting sore, and subscribe to our channel. And also check out the website, naturalathleteclinic.com. I've got tons of blogs, tons of articles, tons of info about natural medicines and how you can use them to become a better athlete.